So it seems like we're facing a bit of a moral dilemma going on right now, particularly when it comes to celebrities or prominent figures, be they Hollywood actors, members of a band, or political talking heads. As of late, the next big thing has been to accuse people of rape, harassment, or assault. Now, this has been going on for a while now, so you may be wondering why I'm choosing to actually delve into this now. Recently, Sylvester Stallone was accused of a pretty brutal rape that he allegedly committed in the 80s. Now, before I get into this, let me clarify that I really don't have any investment in Sylvester Stallone. I don't think I've ever actually watched any of his movies, unless you count the ones where he made a cameo or plays a minor character. I don't even know if the Rocky movies are about boxing or wrestling. I really don't give that much of a shit. But I do have at least some level of respect for how he built his career seemingly from nothing. His story is like the epitome of the American dream, and I respect him for that. But he's become yet another victim in this crusade to, well, rid the government, Hollywood, and even some members of the music industry of men. Now, I know that claim will probably set some people on edge, and let me clarify that yes, I do know that many of these accusations are likely true, and some of them have been proven to be true. In the case of Roy Moore and Harvey Weinstein, there's a lot of incriminating evidence to support that they have harassed or assaulted women. Louis C.K. straight up admitted to whipping his dick out in front of a bunch of women, this of course while he was married. Kevin Spacey, which was probably the most bitterly disappointing for me because I really do love his work, unintentionally gave a response so god-awful that it's pretty much confirmed that all of the allegations against him are more than likely true. But what never ceases to amaze me is how the instant an allegation is made, it's accepted as absolute fact. The sensationalized media and the reactionary nitwits on Twitter immediately, without any kind of evidence to support these claims, jump on the bandwagon of he's a rapist, he's a sexual abuser, and so on. Now, there's a part of me that can't necessarily blame people for that. I think it's almost embedded in us to automatically want to believe these accusations because they're pretty fucking serious. I couldn't imagine what it would be like to be raped or sexually assaulted, and I wouldn't want anyone to go through that. I wouldn't want that to happen to my sister, my cousins, my friends, me, anyone in general. When accusing someone of rape, that's an incredibly serious situation that does need to be dealt with. But here's where I take issue with this whole situation. In every single one of these cases, regardless of how much evidence there is to support or deny the allegations made, people will just immediately side with the accuser. Believe me, I wish I could just side with the women making these accusations. I don't want to be that asshole that looks them in the eye and says, "Well, do you have any proof?" But the problem is, there are a lot of people who have been and likely will be thrown in jail, their lives ruined, their reputations tarnished, their families destroyed over accusations that have later been proven or will later be proven to be false. It's not just some once-in-a-lifetime thing. There are hundreds of examples of accusations that were found to be totally false. Now, the statistics show that the staggering majority of false rape accusations are less than 10% of an estimated 63% that are reported at all. The likelihood of someone falsely accusing someone of rape is statistically very slim. But the reason why I take such serious issue with this is because people blindly believe it without evidence. I'm an analytical guy. I like to break things down, look at the facts, and make a determination based on the empirical data presented to me. So when I see a staggering majority of rape accusations that are totally unfounded and baseless, accusations of crimes committed decades prior, that sets off a lot of red flags in my head. And when it comes to the accusations against Sylvester Stallone, I still have a ton of red flags. First off, the police report supposedly filed when it happened was signed under no prosecution. So let me get this straight. The woman filed a police report at the time that this supposedly happened, a report that literally nobody, not even Stallone, knew of until now, 31 years after the fact, and rather than go ahead and press charges when it happened, she decided to just let it slide? I'm sorry, but how the fuck does that make sense? So he supposedly raped you and threatened you with death if you told anyone, you did tell someone, and then you didn't do anything after that. But now, decades later, you decide to dig up this story and throw it out there with all the other accusations? And on top of that, when I talked about this on Twitter, I had white knights telling me that Stallone also paid off his half-sister to not talk about raping her as well, something that is also unsubstantiated, something that even Stallone's family members are denying and claiming that she was a drug-addicted nutcase, and something that, again, has never been brought up until now, and of which many officials are calling a fabricated blackmail case. But no matter matter how much evidence there is to the contrary, people will still side with the accusers and immediately jump to destroy someone's life and career based on accusations that are not supported whatsoever. Now, of course, it could come out that Stallone did actually do this, in which case I condemn that. Of course I condemn that. Everyone fucking condemns that. But again, that big problem is accusations without evidence. I have had people on Twitter tell me that innocent until proven guilty is apparently a faulty idea and that it supposedly shows the corruption of the courts. I've also received a lot of arguments from emotion. Oh, well, would you tell your daughter she needs to have evidence? What an asinine hypothetical. No, of course not. You wouldn't, I wouldn't, nobody would. That's why I'm not the fucking judge. You could not possibly have an objective, unbiased opinion when it comes to the assault of a friend or family member. That's why family courts don't exist in the West. By your own idiotic logic, if someone you never met were to accuse you of rape, then the courts should side with the accuser regardless of facts or evidence. That's retarded. That's one of the dumbest positions a human being could ever possibly hold. Ruining the lives and reputations of people before the facts have been determined is ridiculous. It's asinine. And just because we're asking for evidence doesn't mean we're accusing you of lying. This is a fallacy I've seen thrown about so repeatedly that it's genuinely starting to piss me off. Now, I'm not religious. I don't believe in a god because there's no empirical evidence or data to support the existence of one, be it the Christian god, the Islamic god, the Norse gods, Hindu gods, Jewish god. Okay, Jews don't have a god, let's be honest. But when I'm arguing with someone that is religious, at no point do I call them a liar. I don't believe they're lying, I'm certain that they actually do believe these things. But that's not the point. When I ask a Christian or a Muslim or a Jew to provide evidence to support their arguments, that doesn't mean I'm accusing them of lying about them. The one making the claim has the burden of proof. The one skeptical of that claim simply has to ask for evidence to support it. So when people rightfully ask for evidence to support these accusations, that doesn't mean that we, in turn, are accusing you of lying. Believe me, we want to believe you. We don't want to say, oh, well, you're just lying to get money out of the deal, because that's a dick move. Nobody wants to say that to another person. But similarly, we don't want to ruin someone's life based on accusations that could very well not be true. It's sad that we have to be skeptical of this subject, because by all means, it should be one of those things that we don't have to be skeptical of. It should be one of those things that just has proof to go along with it, and we don't have to argue about it. But the problem is that in many of these cases, there is no real proof. The problem is that there are many cases where these accusations are false. And what makes it even worse is that falsified statements like this are typically on the radical side of the spectrum, and that pushes the other side to go just as radical in the other direction. Can it even be denied that whether you're on the left or the right, there's extreme tribalism going on? Sam Harris put it pretty well when he said that your position on one subject will likely determine your position on another, even if those two positions are totally unrelated, like the issue of gun control in relation to pro-choice or pro-life. The people siding with the accusers without any evidence are very likely progressives that believe in pro-choice, gun control, allowing Muslim refugees to come into the country, and so on. Inversely, you have the opposite end of the spectrum that thinks the exact opposite of all those positions, that might also try to push a religious, sexist, white supremacist agenda or whatever, because the pendulum is swinging so far to the sides that the few sane people in the middle are drowned out by the crazy fucks on the far left and the far right. I had a guy unironically make the argument that the recent rape accusations are the product of women having rights and that their ability to vote, have the same wages as men, perform most of the same jobs as men, so on and so forth, should be revoked or that it should have never happened in the first place. I think the Amazing Atheist really hit the nail on the head when he said that the anti-SJWs have lost the battle. We threw out science, logic, skepticism, and regressed to religious tribalism and inherently regressive ideologies, refusing to criticize both sides because we're so hellbent on defeating the other. It speaks volumes when time and time again I criticize the hell out of Islam and nobody says a word in protest, but the instant I make so much as a joke about Christianity, people lose their fucking minds over it. No, the recent accusations abroad aren't the product of women having equal rights. That is absolutely retarded. The current political climate in general is the product of tribalism. One side has gone so far to the extreme that we foolishly figured that the other extreme is comparatively better. Fuck facts and evidence, I just want to see those green-haired tumblerinas gone. Fuck nuance and logic, anyone that voted for Trump is a Nazi. And to top it all off, let's also say fuck consistency and values, because there are so many people that are so focused on fighting one side that they will adamantly refuse to offer even the barest criticism of the other for fear of angering one side of their audience, because fuck honesty, where's my Patreon paycheck? This isn't the time for tribalism and senseless trolling and baseless accusations. This is the time for facts, the time for evidence, the time for reason. If you're going to make a claim, don't get pissy when we ask you to back it up. Look, I get it, rape is very likely the most humiliating thing that could ever be done to another person. Talking about it openly is likely the most difficult thing someone can do. But if it happens, don't wait several decades to talk about it. You have to say something immediately, and you have to press charges. Don't tell us that we're accusing you of lying because you decided that you didn't want to press charges at the time that it happened. Changing your mind later doesn't offer more validity to your claim, and you shouldn't go whining about it on Twitter when people ask you for proof that backs your allegations. Again, we do want to believe you. Nobody wants to accuse you of lying after suffering an assault. But if you expect us to take your claim seriously, then you need to back it up. It's your word against the other. I don't even count myself as a Stallone fan. I don't even know the fucking plot of his most noteworthy film. I also don't know anything about either of his accusers. I don't have any personal investment in any of the three parties. So take this from possibly the most unbiased source you'll find in regards to this situation. You have the burden of proof. Back it up or fuck off.